Okay, I'm a little tipsy after all that wine tasting. That is why I've taken this really long walk to this wonderful property of the Taj Residency in Nasik.
And the purpose of my visit here is to meet Chef Osman, who's promised to cook some Indian food with wine.
Okay, this is the first time for me. I have never heard or even tried or even tasted any food, Indian food cooked with wine.
Well, to say so, I will be doing something different for you.
Okay.
Okay, which will have Indian flavors, okay, using Indian spices.
Okay.
Okay, and wine as a flavoring.
Okay.
Where I would be normally substituting it slightly instead of using lime, I would be using wine.
So the wine comes in for the sourness and instead of the lime.
True. Another thing, what is important to note when cooking with wine, uh-huh, okay, you really don't need an expensive wine to cook.
Okay.
Because the flavors really wouldn't stand out so much, okay, especially when using it with spices.
Okay.
So I would normally use a wine which is average in nature,
okay,
but not too high in tannins,
okay,
yet good to taste.
Tannin content, what exactly do you mean by that?
Red wines normally have a tannin content in it, which basically comes from the skin of the grapes after crushing.
Okay.
And some particles of it normally remains in. Uh-huh. And due to that, it adds on to a little tartar to the wine itself.
Okay.
A little acidity content of the wine would normally go a little higher.
Okay.
And most wines, where if you're using in cooking, preferably should not have so much of tannin.
So you use a less acidic wine is what you're saying.
True. With Indian food, especially because you already have the spices which are too overpowering.
Mm.
So here we'll try and create a balance,
okay,
between a few of the spices and the wine.
Okay, now I see some prawns and I see some chicken. And
okay,
what is it exactly that we're going to make?
Okay, I'm going to do two different preparations.
Okay,
one is going to be prawns, which is going to be flavored with turmeric,
okay,
and curry leaves.
Okay. Does it have a name?
This, of course, is going to finish off with coconut cream.
Oh, coconut cream in it.
Right, so you get the sweetness coming through,
uh-huh,
from the coconut cream.
Okay.
As well as the kind of wine that I'm going to use, I'm using a Madeira,
okay,
which is slightly on the sweeter side,
hmm,
a white Madeira. So that will add on to the sweetness of the dish,
hmm,
give it its character to the prawns, which, hmm, again is a little sweeter.
Okay. Does it have a name, as I was asking, or you just call it?
Just call it Kunal's.
Kunal's, okay, no, we'll name it after you.
Okay. Kunal's favorite.
Shall we start?
Okay, what we'll do is, hmm, we'll slightly marinate the prawns with a little flavor, the prawns with a little turmeric.
Okay.
Because turmeric is normally an antiseptic and it's very useful when you're using in seafood. And I'll use the wine
at this point again. Okay.
The wine will be used in two stages over here.
And in goes a little bit of white wine.
And there'll be salt.
Salt.
You get the wine and the turmeric?
Yeah, very nice. Unusual, actually.
Okay, now to begin with, I'm going to use a little bit of butter.
Oh, lovely.
I'm using butter basically because if you want the wine to stand out in this,
mm,
it's preferable to use butter, which is a slight salting agent,
mm,
than using oil.
Okay.
Because oil, normally you tend to overpower your palate and coat it.
Oh, is that so? So the taste of oil or the quality of oil sort of coats the palate?
The quality of oil. The quality of butter, rather.
Okay.
Would be better than using oil.
Okay.
At this stage, we'll put in the spice.
So you put in a little bit of clove. And a little bit of green cardamom.
Once you get the flavors coming through the spices, mm, this time you can add onions, slices in it. Normally just simmer this till the onion just to get a little softer.
A little softer, a little translucent.
Now I will add a little more butter in this here. Okay, and
curry butter.
Curry leaf right in the center there. Then go in the prawns.
Prawns are doing quite well here. Yeah? Here comes the wine.
So we'll just have to deglaze the pan. Deglazing is basically when you use wine, normally would you be used in cooking,
mm-hmm,
whereby when you saute something in a pan,
mm-hmm,
it tends to get stuck to the
Correct.
To the base.
Yeah.
especially in continental cuisine,
yeah,
when you're doing sauces. So it helps release those.
Release the sticker from there.
And get incorporated in the sauces.
Does wine work well with vegetarian Indian food as well?
I wouldn't say so.
Not.
Because vegetables normally tend to have a much milder flavor, and each vegetable has its own characteristic.
Mm.
Though, yes, when we make our kormas and all the flavors, you can make
you're
it out from that.
Killing them, yeah.
Because it really kills the flavors of the vegetables. So that's why vegetables, mostly in continental cuisine, would be preferred, you know, to do with wine. And that too with the sauces more than the vegetables themselves.
Yes, yes, true.
Okay, we have the wine that's reduced now.
Okay.
The green chili?
The green chili. Oh, right at the end you put it, huh?
Yeah, the reason why I've added the green chili towards the end is because we add in the beginning, the spices of the green chili gets really too much into the sauce.
Right. Coconut milk.
We just have to wait for a few moments till it starts thickening by itself,
yes,
and starts coating the prawns.
And it's done.
And it's done with a little bit of salt in the end.
Lovely. So this is one dish called prawns with wine a la Chef Oswin.
There it is.
It is nice and thick. You're wonderful. It's really nice.
Thank you.
I can taste the wine, but does not interfere. It doesn't make it taste alien either from what we are used to eating.
Mm-hmm.
It's just wonderful. So, I think we should move on to the chicken now.